Good morning, everyone, and welcome along to worship at Motherwell South Parish Church this morning. If you're visiting us for the first time, a very warm welcome to you. We have a visitor's book out in the reception area. If you wouldn't mind signing in, we'll drop you a wee card thanking you for worshipping with us. And if you're listening to us live, why not drop us a text and let us know where you're worshipping with us from. And to our own congregation, if you're sitting beside someone you don't recognise, please introduce yourself and welcome them to worship today. Our Lenten lunches raised a profit of £815, and we have decided this year to support the local RNLI. And we have been in touch with, or we're going to be in touch with the Anstruther unit. I believe they are launching a new hut, so we're going to donate the money to them. So we hope you're happy with that. So thanks to everyone. Please note, this Tuesday our care grieve court service has been cancelled, but we'll be back again the third Tuesday of every month. But this week is cancelled. And elders, please note, there's a session meeting directly after worship today, so if you could just stay in the sanctuary. The Cinema Club meets this Thursday at 1 o'clock. The doors open in the sports hall and the film starts at 1:30, and all are welcome. And our annual stated meeting is next Sunday, directly after worship. There'll be no tea and coffee that day, so you're all welcome to stay and join in our annual stated meeting. As that is all our up-to-date news, if you are able, would you please stand for the entry of God's Word?
Good morning. Let us make a joyful noise, for God has been good to us. We come before God with thanksgiving in our hearts, for God has been good to us. Let us worship and give thanks to God, for God has been good to us.
Oh,
We've got quite a few gaps this morning, so I think some people are still on holiday and haven't yet come back. Kids, are you looking forward to going back to school on Monday? Not so sure. I know that during our Easter holidays, we had a wonderful event in the church. We had a bacon at the church over 3 days, because you guys were baking for 2 days, and then we sold all the baking and we enjoyed all the baking on the Saturday, and lots of people helped us with that. So for the congregation, if like me, you were away somewhere and weren't there, or you haven't quite caught up in what's happening yet, then, well, let's watch the clip and we'll see just how much fun these guys had. And maybe you could join in with the singing as well in this clip. Staying on the theme of the bacon, I'm going to hand over to Marlon.
The bacon, as Alan said, was a fantastic success, with 47 children actually attended, 52 registered, but we had some that didn't turn up. The children were amazing, and the sum raised was £655. The children pick the charities that they want the money to go to, and the two charities this year is Alzheimer's Scotland, whom we've actually have supported once before, and YAMS. Now, with the wee girl that put forward YAMS as the charity, none of us had a clue. We had never heard of it. Janice was flipping her phone while the wee girl was talking, while we tried to find out exactly which this charity was. It's a local charity, and I'll hand you over to Rona, who was the founder of it, and she'll tell you just a wee bit about it.
Rhonda. That's okay. Not many Rhondas around. Thank you so much for choosing YAMS. We are a local charity. We're based in Newark Hill, but we serve Scotland. We're called YAMS. It's You Are My Sunshine, which beautifully shortens to YAMS. We started in 2018, based in Newark Hill Library. Tragically, through the loss of my little sister Gemma to suicide in 2017, and it was actually Gemma's daughter, Aaliyah, who was 10 at the time, that came up with the name You Are My Sunshine, because she used to sing that to her and her little brother before they went to bed at night. So I just thought that was beautiful. And we bring sunshine into people's lives. So, yeah, that's how we started our mental health charity, and it's grown massively from there. You may not have heard of us, you may not have accessed our services, but we're there if you really need us. This money really means a lot to us, and it means a lot to small charities. Like, it can be a drop in the ocean to some larger charities, but for us it's vital, because all of our services are completely free of charge to anyone anywhere in the country, regardless of age, regardless of the issues that you're suffering from, whether it's a bad week at work or whether it's you are feeling suicidal yourself, anything at all. We have kids groups, we have free walk and talk, we have fitness, we have craft and chat, but please check us out online and come along. You don't have to be struggling with your mental health, you just maybe want to look after your own well-being, but we're there for you no matter what you're going through. So please look us up, give us a wee follow on social media, and yeah, thank you so much again for choosing Yams. We really do appreciate it. Thank you.
Can have all the children come down, whether you're at Beacon or not, just come down while we present the cheque.
For sharing all of that with us. Right, everybody, come on your feet. I thought rather than do a talk today, we'll do something that gets us moving. So the people who are in the congregation, so you guys who are out there, need maybe a wee bit of space. So just kind of try and don't be scared to use the aisles, just kind of move out a wee bit, give yourselves a wee bit of space. And what I'll do is I'm going to swap with you guys. So you guys go up there. You guys go up there. And I'll go here. So then you can kind of copy what I'm doing. Right, so a few actions that we need first of all. So first of all, give me a salute. And let's walk on the spot as we're saluting. And then another salute that side. And then that's the C. And that's the C. That's it, you got it. Here's another move for you. So we're going to go... Okay. If you're in the congregation, you might just want to jump on the spot, but we'll go, kids, we'll go like that, okay? And then a third one for you. So this is a kind of real sea shanty move. So we're going to go on, wait on one foot and then wait on the other foot. So it's... Come on, congregation, you can join in. That's it, well done. Right, okay. And I think we need one more move, so da-da, come on, and then da-da, da-da, right? So you see, you need a wee bit of space to do this. So Graham, we're going to need some volume on this one, and are we all ready? Let's get the salutes ready.
There once was a ship that put to sea. The name of the ship was a Billy of Tea. The winds blew up her bow, dipped down, oh, below my Billy boys blow. Seen her been 2 weeks from shore, went down on her a right whale bore. The captain called all hands and swore he'd take that whale in tow. In there the weatherman come to bring her sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. Before the boat had hit the water, the whale sail came up and caught her. Hands to the side, harp in and fought her, when she dived down low. She'd not been 2 weeks from shore, went down on her a right whale bore. The captain called all hands and swore he'd take that whale in tow.
Well done. Gosh. Right, what are you all sitting down for? Back on your feet, come on. Up you get. Right, you don't need me to help with this one, so I'll go over here because you know this one. You lead us, we'll join in. Huh.
In my wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence, you won't let go. In the questions, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa-oh. You are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, shining in the darkness. To shore, safe to shore, safe to shore, safe to shore. I won't feel what tomorrow brings. With each morning, I'll rise and sing. My God's love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa-oh. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are my light, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness. I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, I will trust the promise. You will carry me safe to shore.
Feeling okay now? Yeah, feeling a wee bit of exercise is good for us, isn't it? It's really good for us. Let's bow our heads in prayer. I'm going to say a prayer with you guys before you go out for our lighthouse time together. Loving God, we thank you for the chance to enjoy some holidays, to celebrate, to enjoy each other's company. And we thank you for the bacon that we had. We thank you for the wonderful things we made. We thank you for the time and the help from all the adults who came along. And we thank you that we were able to do something good for you are my sunshine. We pray for the work that Rhonda does, and we pray for all the people that she meets and the people that she helps. We ask that you would be with them. We pray that you would support them and strengthen them, that you would encourage them. And now be with us as we go from here into some fun time together through in Lighthouse. We pray that you'd be with all our children. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay. Come with me and pray. Lord God, we come before you and we ask that you would turn our hearts and our minds to you alone. Let there be light in our time together. Let there be laughter in our time together. Let there be peace and calm in our time together. And may you speak to us. May you comfort us, may you guide us, may you guard us. As we turn our thoughts to one of your disciples, Thomas, help us to think about who we are, what we are, whose we are. We ask all of this in Jesus' name, and we say together the prayer he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Morning, Church. National Pets Day. Pets, another one of God's creations to help us express the love that he gave to us, to others, and his creation round about us. Let's read God's word. Today's reading is taken from the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verses 19 to 29. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the disciples were together, with the doors locked for fear of the Jewish leaders, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and side. The disciples were overjoyed when they saw the Lord. Again, Jesus said, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you." And with that, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive anyone's sins, their sins are forgiven. If you do not forgive them, they are not forgiven." Now Thomas, also known as Didymus, one of the 12, was not with the disciples when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." A week later, his disciples were in the house again, and Thomas was with them. Though the doors were locked, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here. See my hands? Reach out your hand and put it into my side. Stop doubting and believe." Thomas said to him, "My Lord and God." Then Jesus told him, "Because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed." Amen. And I'm sure God will bless this reading of his word.
Thank you.
Right, a little quiz for you to start off with today. Do you remember that bit in Question of Sport all those years ago when somebody would dress up in disguise and you had to guess who it was? So that's kind of like this, but it's a Motherwell South version of it. So here's the first person who has been transformed, and you have to guess, or you have to work out who they are.
And have we got news for you?
You better listen.
Get ready, all your lonely girls.
Okay, I hear a few names being mentioned. I hear one name being mentioned. Diane, who do you think it was? You think that was Alistair, do you? Hands up if you agree with Diane and you think it was Alistair. So Alistair's at the back here in the choir. Does anybody think it was somebody else? Well done, Diane, you were right, absolutely spot on. So, that's you, one played, one right. Next one.
Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless these seeds I sow. Someone warm them.
Anybody want to hazard a guess as to who it is? Linda Hannah. Does anybody think it was somebody other than Linda? Well.
Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down.
Well done, well done. It was indeed Linda. Right, one last one for you. We'll save the most difficult one for the last.
You are a sweet ass candy. You're my sugar dandy.
Anybody want a guess? We've narrowed it down to three men in the congregation, apparently. Sorry. Right, come on, was it Robin, Bill, or Tom? Which one was it? Tom? You think so? Tom? Well. Brilliant, well done. I think they all deserve a round of applause for being such good sports. Always amazes me the way in which people transform themselves. I mean, nowadays you can basically go out onto the high street, you can get a nip and a tuck, a bit of Botox, book your holiday to Turkey and get your turkey teeth and your hair restoration, and you are a new person overnight. I mean, it really is, it's as simple as that. But of course, as we all know, the problem with that kind of transformation is it's external. It's on the outside. And we all know that age does catch up with us. No matter how much Botox or nips and tucks we get, eventually age takes its toll and it begins to show. And of course, that is just the outward appearance. What about the inward appearance? What about a transformation of the soul or a spiritual transformation? That's something that really does create a new person. So that's what I want us to think about just for the next few moments. And to help me do that, I'm going to turn to that reading that Stuart shared and the person that he spoke about, that he read about, Thomas, the disciple of Jesus. So just to put it in context a wee bit, Thomas was one of the followers of Jesus. And in today's reading, he's watched Jesus being crucified, being nailed to a cross. And he is down, despondent, lost, and just doesn't know which direction to turn in next. Now, this had been a man who previously had followed Jesus, and on one occasion had even said that he would die for Jesus. But now we find him doubting, despondent, lost. He's totally changed. I wonder if there are times in life when we feel like that. Times when we just have lost our passion, our spiritual passion. It's gone, it's disappeared. There are lots of different things can cause us to lose our spiritual passion. One of them is being burnt out. Wonder how many of us have suffered from burnout. You get pulled in so many different directions that you just feel the life getting sucked out of you. I know that some of you care for elderly parents and you care for children. Others amongst us find that the pressures at work are so debilitating, it takes a huge toll on us. There may be others who struggle with debt, who struggle with addiction issues. But these are all things that can leave us feeling totally burnt out, devoid of energy, devoid of direction. Some of us can feel that we've lost our spiritual passion because we're hurt. Now, that hurt can be caused from different things. It can be caused by grief, loss, bereavement, pain, illness. I know people who've been hurt in churches. And sometimes they're hurt in churches because of the actions of leaders within the church. I know that I have hurt people in the past. I know that my predecessor hurt people when she was here. I met one man, I must tell you this wee story. I think it was my very first year at Motherwell South. I was out doing a visit and I met this one man and he had been an elder in the church. And he said to me, "You'll no get me in the door of that church." I thought, oh no. And I said, and why? Put on my serious face, and why would that be? And he said, oh, he went on to tell me it was about the actions of a minister. I assumed it was my predecessor. No, it was Jim Seth. Now, I don't know when Jim Seth was here. Was it about 40 years ago or something? But, you know, obviously the actions, it taught me two things. It taught me that hurt lasts a long time, but it also reminded me that sometimes folk just have a chip on the shoulder and they're just, you know, they're going to have to deal with that at some point. It's their issue. Beware the chip on the shoulder. Don't live your life with a chip on your shoulder. Goodness me. But hurts do debilitate us in our spiritual passion. So there's two we've had so far. We've had being burnt out, hurt, disillusionment. That can cause us to lose our spiritual passion as well. The thing about Thomas is that in the reading that Stuart shared with us, it's evident that Thomas was not present when Jesus met with his disciples for the first time, when he had been raised from the grave. Thomas wasn't there. He's gone AWOL. And that very often happens to us when we are debilitated spiritually, when we've had the inside ripped out of us. We feel that we're not there, we're not in the moment, we're not present. And our relationship with God is often a very distant relationship. That seemingly is what has happened to Thomas. He's heard rumors about the resurrection of Jesus, but he's not willing to entertain that idea because he is totally wallowing in the moment. He's surrounded by this dark place, by this difficult place where he's lost and empty, and he cannot move on from that. I wonder how many of us have felt like that before. So how do we deal with a loss of spiritual passion? How do we rediscover God? How do we reconnect our souls with the godly? One word, hot. Let me take each letter, just 1 minute on each letter, H. Honesty. H stands for honesty. We've got to be honest. We've got to be honest with ourselves. We've got to be honest with God. We've got to go to God in prayer and say, I've lost my spiritual direction. I've lost the flame that once burned bright. It's gone. It's dampened. And it's only when Thomas is honest with himself and with the disciples that he then has this amazing encounter with the risen Christ. But it takes honesty on his part. That's the first step. So for us too, we must be honest. We must come before God in a state of honesty and say, here is my current circumstance. Help. Help me, please. So that's H. Next letter is O. Openness. We've got to be open to God and to the way that he works in our lives. Thomas was open to the risen Jesus. He went and met with the risen Jesus. Now, that's a privilege that we are often not afforded. But he goes and he meets with the risen Lord. And what does Jesus say to him? He says, put your finger in my wounds. That's pretty gross. These are the wounds from the cross, from the crucifixion. And he invites Thomas to place his finger in them. But Thomas is open to doing something different. And sometimes when we are spiritually lost or spiritually dried up, we've got to be open to doing something different, open to changing the direction that our lives are going in. Don't be honest before God and then continue to do the stuff that you're always doing. Be honest and then be open to God changing the direction that life is going in. So that's the second one, O for openness. And the last one, T, H-O-T, T, the touch of Christ. Be aware of the touch of Christ. Jesus touches us in different ways. Sometimes it's the still awareness of his presence when we are grieving the loss of someone we love. Sometimes it's the words of somebody who speaks to us and says something. Wow. And that's God talking to us. Maybe it's something more dramatic than that. But be aware of the touch of Jesus upon your life.
I was battered and scarred, and the auctioneer thought it scarcely worth his while to waste much time on the old violin. But he held it up with a smile. What am I bid, good folks, he cried. Who'll start the bidding for me? £1. £1? Then two. Only two? £2. And who'll make it three? £3 once. £3 twice. Going for three. But no. From the room far back, a grey-haired man came forward and picked up the bow. Then wiping the dust from the old violin and tightening the loosened strings, he played a melody pure and sweet as the angel sings. The music ceased, and the auctioneer, with a voice that was quiet and low, said, "What am I bid for the old violin?" And he held it up with the bow. £1,000, and who'll make it two? £2,000, and who'll make it three? £3,000 once, £3,000 twice, and going and gone, said he. The people cheered, but some of them cried. We do not quite understand. What changed its worth? Swift came the reply, the touch of the master's hand. And many a man with a life out of tune, and battered and scarred with sin, is auctioned cheap to a thoughtless crowd, much like the old violin. A mess of pottage, a glass of wine, a game, and he travels on. He is going once, and going twice. He's going and almost gone. But the master comes, and the foolish crowd never can quite understand the worth of a soul and the change that is wrought by the touch of the master's hand.
Our doxology is one we haven't sung in, oh gosh, 5 or 6 years. I have good reason for asking you to sing it really, really well if you can. Let's uplift our offering. Let's have a seat just for a second. And just a few hellos from those watching online. Kay and John say konnichiwa. Konnichiwa to you too. And a message from Frank and Elizabeth, who are watching in Law Village. And they send their best wishes to the congregation. And also a message from Ruth Gray to say good morning to my church family watching in Jersey. This is a favourite of yours, this last hymn, but watch out for the little change about halfway through it. May the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with us all this day and forevermore.